some very sobering news. The NBA has decided to suspend game play following the conclusion of tonight's games. Now, during the hiatus of the suspension, they'll figure out and try to determine what the next steps will be. But the word that just came out just moments ago is the NBA is going to temporarily suspend the season from now. Who knows what's going to happen going forward?
Welcome back, everyone, to the MSG 150 at Home presented by Chase, Vilpito, and Alan Hahn, and Wally Zerbiak. And we say hello to Mike Breen. And Mike, it is so great to see you. How you doing, pal?
Really great to see you, and your band is back. Nice to see all you guys. Hopefully we'll see you in person soon.
Yeah, absolutely. So we in-bumped the segment with you and Clyde in Atlanta on March 11th, almost 7 weeks ago. It's 7 weeks ago on Wednesday. And you guys are calling the game, the three of us are in the studio, and we get word that the NBA has suspended the season at the end of that night. We didn't know who tested positive for COVID-19, but we knew somebody had tested positive prior to the Utah-OKC game. So you're monitoring all this, calling a game with the announcement that's out that the season's been suspended. What was that like for you and Clyde?
It was one of the strangest telecasts, Billy, we've ever had. Our crew, producer Spencer Julian, director Howie Singer, did everything to give us all the information, keep us informed. And going into the game, the thing we kept talking about was we were hearing that we were going to be doing games with no fans, and thinking about, boy, that's going to be strange going to arenas and no fans. And then all of a sudden it completely turned. And it was really jarring to hear that they were going to suspend the season for a while. And you had no idea, obviously, how much. I remember I felt so out of sorts at one point in the second half. I apologized to the viewers. I was so distracted by what this meant, knowing that this could be, you know, an iconic moment in the NBA that none of us wanted to have happen. So I was really thrown for it, and it affected the broadcast as far as I was concerned for me.
Yeah, definitely, Mike. It's been crazy times and unprecedented times for sports in general. Just how have you been filling your time, staying sharp? Hopefully the season does come back soon. It sounds like the NBA is kind of putting some things in place to head that direction. Knock on wood, it all works out. How have you been staying busy?
Well, it's been a great chance for all of us to do things we've wanted to do. And so I've been exercising. I lost 30 pounds. I've taught myself how to speak French.
I've gone the other way, Mike.
And I've taught myself how to play guitar. I finished the novel that I've been trying to write for so long. So I haven't done any of those things. I'm going to attempt to read a book at some point. I've cut my nap schedule down from 3 naps to 2 naps a day. You know, just seriously, like everybody, getting some exercise, reading up on everything, binge watching TV shows, watching old sports programs and getting a kick out of that. And most importantly, getting some great time with my family.
And the one thing we all have to believe is how fortunate we are, you know, obviously that we can joke about this stuff and find things to do to keep us busy throughout this time. And we don't have live sports. You mentioned we're watching old games, classic games and whatnot, but we do have a documentary on the Chicago Bulls, The Last Dance. It's something you lived through as a broadcaster with the Knicks through the 90s. And there aren't great memories from the Knicks standpoint, but you did get to see that team, that iconic team, up close and personal. As you watch this documentary, do a lot of those memories come back?
Oh, it sure does. And like you said, it was painful, some of those matchups, obviously with the exception of 94. But I've said before, Michael Jordan, as great as he is, and we all acknowledge that and respect and in awe of what he was able to do. At that time, for me personally, as a young Knick broadcaster, I hated him because he ended the season of my favorite team early all the time. He always broke our hearts. But watching it now from a distance and getting a chance to relive some of it, a couple of things stick out. Number one, I think for the younger generation to be able to see him and to see just how great he was in so many different ways, it's wonderful for the younger generation who never had a chance. But number two, to see how the game has changed so much on and off the court, and watching, especially last night, the hatred that still exists between the Bulls and the Pistons is palpable. I mean, it was thrilling to watch. Just so many different aspects of him that are enjoyable to watch. The fact how he was willing to change his game at the height of his game because he knew for them to take the step to win a championship, showing how unselfish he was and what his priority was. It, just so many aspects of it that I find riveting.